Here with Coach Suzy Barcomb and senior Kamira Sanders after Seattle U's 82-80 overtime win over Utah Valley here at the Redhawks Center. Coach, this was a wild one, a roller coaster of a game. You got down early and then finally came back there late in the fourth quarter. Kamira had the big second half. I think she had 21 points after halftime on the day. What do you think of the game?
I think our fans got their money's worth today, so I don't know what we're charging for tickets, but that was well worth it. Gutsy game for us. Just the fact that we had Joe foul out, Cheen foul out, Kinsey go out, and you're playing Leilani Pete at the five. So we battled. We stayed within distance reach of them, and I thought the fourth quarter we really dug deep and were able to tie it up. So key baskets clearly by so many people, but Kamira caught fire in the fourth quarter and in OT. I was just telling her that I thought they were really, really fresh in the first few quarters, and then she was going against subs because everybody had been fouling. So key baskets by her, and Haley was phenomenal again tonight.
What did Kamira do to get going there in the second half? Obviously, she kind of got her whole game going there, penetrating, and then she also had a couple step-back threes, and she was finding other players. She had four assists, mm-hmm. Getting out on the open floor with five steals. What was working for her in the second half?
She just played Kamira basketball. Everything was working for her in that regard. So I think in the beginning, it was a little difficult for her to get going. They were plugging the paint so well with Josie and the paint inside. And it's just the difference of not having to go up against that big person. And then when you have Courtney hitting and you have Haley hitting, and then we just kept on trying to find her mismatches. So when that happens, then she gets a one-on-one instead of having to beat someone one-on-two. Ran some really nice back doors to free them up. They did a really good job of denying us the ball. So. Really well played game in that regard. We had some key turnovers, and we were really, really lucky to win it. We really were.
Kamira, what are your thoughts on today? Obviously, you have a big game, 25 points on 9 of 13 shooting. You hit all six of your free throws. You had five steals. You played 38 minutes of the game. Last chance to play Utah Valley potentially in your career, and obviously wanting to get some revenge on earlier in the season. What was the motivation for you? How did you feel going there throughout the second half?
I want to win. I want to win every game from here on out. I want to win the tournament. I want to go back to the NCAA tournament. I'm not even thinking about, who's playing who this weekend on the other side of who's in our conference, because I'm just I'm just dialed in. Who are we playing? I need to execute this scout. I need to execute our plays. I need to execute on defense. I need to do everything to make sure that we win, because we need to win. And I know that, I need to perform well to help us do that.
All right. Coach Haley, we saw again today, first career double-double, 18 points, 11 rebounds, hit the free throws late in regulation, and then hit the three to win the game at the end of overtime. We've been looking for her, obviously, as a difference maker for you here, and we saw another example of it today. What'd she bring?
I mean, it's just the mismatch, and I think that's another reason why you'll see Kamira and Liv get more open, with the fact that you have Haley on one side, you have Court on the other side. And with JoJo going so well down low, it just makes us more of a complete team. You saw that when we played Cal Baptist, our scoring totals. So it's pretty hard to guard when you have this many people scoring for you. It's what do you want to take away? And I think what you saw today is they only could take so much away, and then Kamira caught fire. And that's because of Haley hitting and transition threes. We just did a really, really good job of recognizing some of our mismatches inside.
Kamira, what's it like to know you have that spacing on the floor with Courtney and Haley? They made six threes between them today. Joe made three threes. What's that like to have that space for you to be able to penetrate?
It's great because, that's where I get all of my production. So when I start going in and I catch fire like that, then it only forces them to help in and help off of other people. So then it's just kind of just, a domino effect. So it's I'm going in and I'm making, so then they come out or they come in on me, and then that opens up our shooters, and I hit my shooters and they're hitting. So then they have to go back out, and it's kind of just pretty much a domino effect, because you got to take something away. And if we're both hitting, then, that's hard. That's hard to guard. Even if we were on the other side of that, that's hard to guard.
And again for you, Kamira, late in that game there we saw in regulation and in overtime, what's that like for you, I guess, mentally, when there's so many timeouts where it's there's a play and then a timeout and then a play and then a timeout, you're advancing the ball and they're shooting free throws and kind of playing that game. What's that like to just go back to that huddle and know each time, okay, I really need to focus up here and get this play and execute the next play?
All right, if I'm understanding it right, it's just that's my mental break, where I'm catch your breath, refocus, re-huddle, make sure everybody's on the same page. we have like set things, like, you know, if it's on a miss, we do something. If it's on a make, we do something. So I just, you know, try and get everybody reorganized. I'm like, everybody take a deep breath. You know, like if refs are against us, we can't, you know, we can't control that. So just like push that out of your mind, you know, next play, things like that. So.
Okay. Coach, what's the play call there? You're down by, I guess it was tied, or no, were you down by one with 10 seconds left?
In overtime.
Oh. You were down 80 to 79. And then Haley, Kamira drove.
It was a blown play, wasn't it?
Kamira drove and then found Pete.
Yep. That's not what we were supposed to run, but but they did a good, they took it away from us. So, I mean, that was the play where Haley got fouled down low. That was a call play call. We played her being the five because it was a mismatch. But the play where Haley hit that, we were trying to run, I think, a flat, maybe a flat for somebody, or we were trying to run a gray zone, and they blew it up really, really well. Kamira attacked, and it was wide open. So, and knocked down. Haley had passed up another three. There was a time where we had three threes. They were all great shots, and that's all we kept on saying. Those are great-looking shots. Take them, take them, take them. So she passed one up, and she wasn't going to pass that one up. Dialed in. It looked good from right when it left her hand.
So this is three in a row now, and you get keep it rolling here with two more home games next week, New Mexico State and UTRGV coming to the Redhawks Center. You know, obviously the next week here, you have a couple days to regroup and get things sorted out, but do you feel like things are coming together like you expected?
I mean, this was a really tough game, and we talked about that we have to have sweeps and splits. We can't get swept, and so this was one of these games where we could have been swept, and so we were just fighting for a split. And these next two games coming up again, we have to fight for splits. We played well enough to win at UTRGV. We didn't come out ahead on OT. Played amazing first quarter at New Mexico State. And then we just fell apart. So this, our focus is making sure we get two splits coming up and trying to climb up the ladder. The WAC is wide open. I mean, Kansas City's playing really, really well, and GCU is playing well. They just limit the amount of possessions you're going to have, and if you don't shoot a high percentage, you're not going to win the game. They've really taken the air out of it. It's very smart.
All right, an exciting win for the Redhawks here. They make it three in a row with an 82-80 win over Utah Valley in overtime here this afternoon at the Redhawks Center.